Good morning, everybody. And welcome. Do we have any first-time visitors here today? Okay, it doesn't look like it. And if you cannot hear me okay, please just let me know. And we will go right into the announcements. And the first announcement for the sponsored flowers, Lisa, if you can go back to that for just a second. We did have flowers. I believe they were sponsored by Florence in loving memory of her husband, Thomas. So I just wanted to acknowledge that. Thank you. And for the next one, for our preaching series this summer, for our guest speakers, next week we will have Michael Thomas preaching a message. And then after that, it will be Bonnie Benjamin. So we look forward to hearing both of those. And the next slide for the next one. Okay, August birthdays. So we've got quite a few August birthdays to acknowledge. Amazing that it's almost August. And we will do one quick group happy birthday. We won't mention all of the names, so I think for the names we sing God Bless You. And I think that's the usual thing. And Terry, if you don't mind playing a quick happy birthday, and we will acknowledge these people. That's right. Okay, the next one, A Passion for the Planet, a movie concert for, oh, sorry, Marianne. Okay, yes, this is the Passion for the Planet. I don't know that the date is up on there. I think it's August 3rd. I think that was printed. But if you want more information on that, Pleasant Street in Orange, 6:30 p.m. I don't see the date, but I do believe that's August 3rd. Perfect. Okay, great. Thanks, Lisa. And then August 18th at 10 o'clock, I'm not going to read it word for word, but we've got our service at the South Athol Methodist Church. That is going to be the only service that day. I know I went last year. It was really fun. It was a couple of different churches, some great music. So that's up there. If you want to go to the next one, yes, it is the tropical service. So you can dress however you like, but if you want to wear tropical stuff, the music is really great. And I know that is the first service that Reverend Candy is going to be back, so we will get to meet and greet her and see her on that day as well. There's a couple of pictures. I'm not sure if they were last year, but it was a really, really nice time. This one here, I'm not seeing the slides that great, but I think this is the back to school event in Fish Park. Looks like Thursday, August 22nd. So a lot of family fun for that. That would be a nice event to go to. Hopefully you can see it a little bit better up there. And I believe we are also in the church collecting folders. Picture of the folders. If you wanted to get some, you can bring those in. You can see Marianne for any questions, and that would be one of our contributions to the kids getting ready to go back to school. Okay, September 8th, the church picnic right at the beautiful Silver Lake Pavilion. So just save the date for that. Sounds far away, coming right up. And I think there will be a sign-up sheet too for anybody that wants to bring anything. And we will start the passing of the peace. So teacher, Jesus, teacher of love, be with all of us. Can turn now and greet one another with a peace that comes from living the way that Christ shows us.
Thank you. childhood.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you.
Yep. Leader, on this day, we gather to draw closer to God and each other. Whatever we feel or experience, you are there and working all things for good.
We are free to ourselves and for you, and know that you created us to live a full and abundant life.
Healing God, thank you for your kindness to each of us.
You work in ways that we can't see, but your love never fails.
And now we will begin our opening hymn, It Is Well With My Soul. The words should be up on the screen. There's also an insert in your book. And at the same time, the ushers will come around. If there are any prayer concerns, they will come around and collect those. Also, if you're able to stand, please do so.
Thank you.
Healing God, thank you for being a wonderful counselor. Mighty God, everlasting Father, in peace, Prince of Peace, help us to open our hearts to all of you are trying to show us. We pray this in Jesus' name, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. You ready? Okay, so we were asked to share a spirit sighting from our vacation. So TJ and I took a road trip at the end of June into the beginning of July. We traveled to South Carolina to visit my sister, and we stopped in Virginia, North Carolina on the way. After our stay with my sister in South Carolina, we were driving to Williamsburg, Virginia, to spend a couple of days before we headed home. We are about 3 hours into our journey, about 100 miles into North Carolina, when we stopped for gas and food. TJ here, if you don't know him, is a big Chick-fil-A fan. So pretty much whenever we're on the road and there's a Chick-fil-A, that's where we go. So there happened to be a gas station and a Chick-fil-A. So we went in, and it's very busy down there. You guys think it's busy here, it's really busy there. So we were waiting actually quite a while for our food after we ordered. And this woman came into Chick-fil-A, and she asked the gentleman next to us if he had jumper cables. And he said, no, I don't. And she looked kind of dismayed. So I said, I'm pretty sure I have jumper cables in my car. I said, I usually always do unless my husband took them out. So I said, we'll get our food. And I said, I'll come out and check. She's like, okay, I'll be waiting outside. So we got our food and we went outside, and she was waiting right at the curb. And she goes, oh, that's our truck right there in the center lane. And we looked up and the truck was parked next to our car, which in this crazy kind of busy parking lot was kind of funny in itself. So I checked in the back of the car. I did have my jumper cables. We pulled the jumper cables out. I handed them to her husband, and he started to go about hooking up the car. And I said, she asked where we were from, and I said Massachusetts. And she said, we're coming up from South Carolina. We're traveling to Maryland to meet my parents and my husband's parents. And so TJ was in the car, and he looked up, and he's like, Mom, look. And the gentleman was wearing a Chapin shirt. And Chapin happened to be the town my sister lived in South Carolina. So I said, wow, it is a Chapin shirt. She goes, oh, yes, we live in Chapin, South Carolina now. And I said, my sister lives in Lake Murray. And she goes, oh, we live on Lake Murray. And it turns out they lived less than a mile from my sister's house. My sister actually jogs by her house every day. So that's not it. So as we're talking to them, and where the cars are jumping with the cables and everything, we're talking, and it turns out he grew up in Springfield, Mass, and she grew up in Lynn. So that's our spirit sighting. In North Carolina. Okay. All right.
So did the truck start?
The truck did start. Turns out Dad left the jumper cables in the boat and didn't have them in the truck for the road trip. And there was a Walmart next door. I think they were going to get a battery, so we got them to the Walmart. So that's it. Okay, so we have the scripture for today. Yeah. Okay. The Lord is my shepherd; I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul, and he leads me in the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and you anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me in all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long.
Rebecca and TJ, thank you so much. That was great. One thing that I did forget to do too is ask if there were any other announcements. I don't know, Pat, if you have any or anybody have any. I just wanted to make sure to give you that opportunity. Okay, it doesn't sound like it. So we will go to the guest preachers. And I did a lesson today on mountains and valleys. And part of that is because I love mountains and valleys. What I mean by that is the mountains times are the times we all want to be on when you're feeling on top of the world. The valleys are kind of the pits nobody wants to be in. We learn a lot there. But I just have always loved that reference, the biblical references to mountains, valleys, paths, walking, nature, anything like that. But before that, thank you so much for having me here. I wanted to acknowledge how much I'm glad to be here and how much I love this church. And I'm from Athol originally. I moved back 2 years ago and came here. And I just really cannot communicate how much you all mean to me. I've met a lot of friends here, even like the casual conversations, but I am so proud of this church. I am so proud of all of you for the love, the non-judgment, the acceptance of other people, the desire to help one another, the desire to look beyond yourselves. Like, it is something that touches me so deeply, and I'm just so grateful. And this is like just such a gift from God. So thank you. I also really appreciated the lesson last week, Christine, on Life Simply Lived. I like the personal sharing, the examples provided. I think they're really powerful. And I did walk, like, I know the hope when we come to church, it's about community and talking to each other, but you also want to walk away with a little something, draw closer to God, draw closer to each other. So I did really value that, and I've sat quietly for a few minutes myself this week. So back to mountains and valleys. Throughout life, we can have a wide range of experiences. That's not unique to me. That is all of us. And most importantly, God is there, and He does invite us to walk with Him. And one of the ways we can do that is by inviting Him into our lives and listening for His voice. And Psalm 119, 105 says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." And it's something to really hold on to because He gives us just enough light needed along the way for any of our paths to lead us and guide us. And in my life, I feel like I've been richly blessed beyond wildest expectations. And each day, truthfully, I wake up with just a gratitude to be alive. Like, sometimes I'll just move my hands and I'm like, I'm so grateful I'm still alive. And it's family, it's relationships, it's community, being able to see, being able to walk, have fresh air, a job, a home, and a place of belonging. I am filled with gratitude of what God has given me. And I really marvel at what He's done for me. And I do feel like it's the simple experiences that are really the mountaintop experiences. I've also had tremendous loss and spent time in the deepest pits of the valley. And it's a place that no one wants to be, but through it all, we can trust God. And just like Rebecca read in Psalm 23, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for You are with me." And the psalm does go on to say, "Surely goodness and love will follow me and you, any of us, all the days of our lives, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." And it's so comforting to think, like, no matter how low of a valley you're in, there is goodness and love. It will follow you all the days. So I'm grateful to God's graciousness and His compassion, which is a huge part of His character. And Lisa, if we can go to the next one. Thank you. This is a picture of me, my husband Phil, he's here, and our three kids. There's Jen with a kind of the curlier blonde hair, the Kim, and then Nick in the back. And this picture was York Beach, July 22nd, 2017. This is the last picture that we have of the five of us together. And we had a great time that weekend, and the summer was moving forward. And 1 week later, early morning of July 30th, 2017, Nick passed away unexpectedly at 19. And this threw all of us, my mom's here today too, all of us into a valley. I would describe it more as a pit. You know, a valley, I don't think, you guys have been through some hard times. I don't think a valley sometimes does justice. And none of us felt equipped to deal with that. And some of the experiences and emotions of that time were shock, horror, devastation, unable to help myself or my family, horrific sorrow, humiliation that God would take our son away, and I had no idea where he was. Did he have food, clothes, a safe place? These were no longer my responsibility, and it felt humiliating, like this was taken away. Perception is not always reality, but looking back to that time, I really felt like I was bald and naked, like stripped of dignity, just stripped of everything, to have him gone. It just stripped of what mattered and left to bleed is how I felt. Unable to go back to work. I tried to go back to work after a couple of weeks. I could read sentences and I understood English, but I couldn't make sense of them. I couldn't work. Unable to go into stores and drowning in pain and tears over what Nick lost and the pain that tore through our family. And looking back 7 years later, I feel like this is the price of deep love. And any one of us that loves would pay this again in an instant. Like, I love him, I'll love him forever. He's always my son. I'll pay that price. And I know that God allows us to experience some really hard emotions, but he is always there, and that matters, and that is bigger than our sorrow. Lisa, if we can do the next pic. Thank you. And this is a picture of Kim and Nick. This is her graduation in 2013. He was 3 years younger. And in the days following his loss, we struggled. All four of us really struggled. And eventually that pain, though huge, became bearable with little rays of hope coming in. All four of us eventually went back to work. Kim even started school. And we were limping forward, but we were moving forward. And we were even experiencing some moments of peace. And that ended on April 8th, 2020, when Kim died too, at age 24. And one of the first friends that I spoke with, I think it was the next day, was my pastor, my friend Pastor Bill. And his words still resonate with me today. And he said, "This is larger than us." And in spite of the horror that I was feeling, and I call it fresh hell, because I feel like I want to acknowledge the experience for what it is. I really felt some semblance of surrender hearing that. And we still need to walk this path. And this valley was another experience of grief, pain, fear, and horror. And this time there was hopelessness, because I felt that in the 2+ years where after Nick died and Kim was still alive, we were pushing and pushing and pushing and trying to get back to some semblance of, I would never say normalcy, but being able to live and being able to exist without pain and without tears. And I felt like we were thrown back. I felt like our family was freaks of nature. Like, I can understand you have this one big tragedy, but to have a second one come in and land on your lap, we're not. And things can happen, but again, that was how I felt. I felt deep sorrow over losing Kim and all that she lost. This second time, there was also a surrender, because I felt like I really had nothing left to give. But through it all, God's gentleness is there, and he doesn't leave us no matter what. And now, it's been over 4 years since Kim's gone and 7 years from seeing Nick or either one of them. And I think about the things that are most missed. And I go back to Christine's lesson from last week, and it's funny because it's really the simple things. And I took some time this week, actually yesterday, to write out just a couple of simple things that are missed, right? When I think about what really mattered, like what do I miss the most? And it's so simple. It's always somebody being home and activity in our house. There was always cars in and out of the driveway. Kim's home, Nick's out, Nick's coming home, Phil's home, right? Just that activity. And just being home and going, anybody want to run a market basket with me? Anybody want to go to Savers? We lived in New Hampshire at the time, and we all loved going to the thrift stores, and Savers was the favorite. And it's like, oh, I'll take a ride with you, Mom, or yeah, I'll go. Like, just people around, sitting on the deck, doing a whirlpool in our swimming pool. Kim was a musician and Nick had some great music, and just going, what artist is that? Like, what music are you playing? I like it. Those simple conversations. Anybody want to come on for a walk? I'm going to walk the dog. Sure, I'll watch that movie with you. Yes, I'd love to hear your funny work story. Do you want to hear my funny work story? Yeah. Nick, I'll take a ride with you. Anybody want a smoothie? Anybody feel like cookies tonight? Hey guys, come to the window and check out this massive storm. End of day stories, daily happenings told from their perspective, camaraderie laughs, and just being silly. Next slide, Lisa, please. This is a sunset picture. It's actually School Street. I walk around here a lot, and it doesn't really do it justice, but these are just simple things. And just looking at that list of the kids and what is missed most, all of these simple everyday things I think are really like mountaintop experiences, and something as simple. Like for me, it's seeing a pink sunset. It might be something different for you, but I do feel like God's love and beauty are incredible. A favorite scripture, 1 Corinthians 13, love always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. And now when I go into situations and I'm a little bit sad, mostly I feel great joy, I think love protects us. Love protects you, and it protects me, and it protects those that even if they're not with us today and we can't see them and we don't know maybe exactly what they're doing, love protects them. And today in my life, I feel God's great love for me. I feel a great love for everyone here. And that's a gift of God, that he's filled my heart, that I can walk around with a lot to give. And he has filled my heart with the ability to really love others. And I will say, your joy is my joy. Your sorrow is my sorrow. And I'm so grateful to be alive and to be able to walk and know him and to live in community. And then there's just simple things of recent. And Phil and I manage this little garden bed, and we're seeing how much it produces. And the other day I gave a friend some extra produce, some vegetables. And later on that day she sent me a picture, like it was a plate of her dinner plate. And she goes, it's so good. And it made my day. And it's like, that to me, that's a mountaintop experience that it made somebody happy. Taking a walk. I live 5 minutes from here. I've met a lot of neighbors along the way, and we have these everyday interactions. They're just so funny, and I love them all. Volunteering and connecting with others. Hearing when the train comes through town. My husband's from Malden, and he's only lived in Athol for 2 years. And I just remember as a kid, I loved hearing the train. And we both, like, it's such a treat. I don't know if anybody else feels that way, but it's like, oh, the train. Hearing when my daughter Jen has a great day and is happy, fresh morning summer air, and standing outside looking at the stars. And it's even little things. Hearing about Reverend Candy and Cindy's adventure. Some of us are on Facebook, and Reverend Cindy's posting a lot. They're good posts. They're wild, and I just love it. In a recent trip to the Petersham Farmers Market with Pamela Dean, we got there, and we didn't rush in and out. We sat there for 2 hours. We talked to vendors. We listened to music and just sat in beautiful weather. And then the other night, walking back uptown from a downtown meeting, and there was this fresh breeze, and I just had such a sense of fullness and gratitude and wonder, and I'm on Main Street like this. Like, it's so good to be alive. And Lisa, one more slide. This is actually a picture of a magnet that I bought at the farmer's market, but I love it. It's moonlight illuminating these lilies, and I feel like this image of these lilies shining bright under the moonlight, it reminds me of the power of God's love and the light working in me and the light working in you. And it is, I feel like that picture is like magic, and I feel like what he does for us is magic. So, closing, God has many great things in store for all of us, and I look forward to hearing more of your joys and your mountain experiences as well. Amen. We are going to move to the prayers of the people, and I do have a few prayer requests here, and then I'll open it up to see if there are any more. And I have one, and if I've mispronounced something, or and if you're comfortable, just let me know. But we've got one to pray for Davina to see the dentist as soon as possible. Continue prayers for my friend Sherry's daughter, Tiffany, getting better, but still a long road of recovery from Jason. Yes, and I continue to pray for her during the week as well. Prayer for all who suffer with PTSD. And prayer for Jean Lambert, absolutely. Are there any others?
Got a few here from our visitors online, but personally, I would like to offer, I didn't write them down, but prayers for Bruce and Karen Banks, Susan Katotis, and David Harris. Marlene Chasen is joining us online. Thank you for the prayers last week. My surgeon appointment went well. Could have been so much worse. God is great. And again, thank you everyone for your prayers. Sherry Berube, happy to welcome my newest great nephew, Jack, to the world on this past Friday. Nancy Mooney, good morning to my church family. I am joining you today as I continue to care for Leo now that he is home after 2 months in the hospital and rehab. He is making good progress. Thank you for keeping us in your thoughts and prayers. And as well, thank you to all of our military and our first responders for keeping us free. Thank you.
Alex? Thank you, Alex. Tracy? Thank you so much. It doesn't look like we have any others. We will. Loving and gracious God, we ask that you be with us as we do pray, and we will first have a moment of silence and then a time of prayer. So let us be together in prayer. Healing God, we lift up all the people who are mentioned today in situations before you, but also others who maybe didn't ask because you know what they need. We thank you that you are good and ask that you be with each person mentioned for anything they are going through. We also thank you for all the joys. Loving and gracious God, at all times and in all places, we lift up our prayers to you and we pray, as always, that we already know the answers. We pray that you hear the prayers of your people. Amen. And we will now have our offertory. I'd like to thank our Heavenly Father in advance for all that we are about to receive in this.
so far away. You're not alone. Stop holding on. Just be healed. Your world's not falling apart. It's falling into place. I'm on the throne. Stop holding on and just be.
And we will now have our closing hymn, Blessed Assurance. You can stand if you're able to. And there's an insert or there are words up on the screen. Great. Thank you so much, Terry. Everybody can be seated. And just for some final words, thank you so much, everybody, for being here today. and loving and gracious God, as we go from this place of worship on this last Sunday of July, we ask that you fill our hearts with love, kindness, and joy so that we may go out into the world sharing our peaceful, faithful hearts with one another. And I wish you to go in the peace of Christ. Amen.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whispering words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whispering words of wisdom, let it be. Sound of music, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.